Suzanne, when does the idea of the marriage of Claude Monet and Joan Mitchell come from?
You know, it's a very, as always, a very artistic proposition. I have here the artist and the artist who have rediscovered Monet, not the impressionist, but the last works of Monet are the artist. They were expressionist abstract.
She was.
No, they were. So the first were all the group of abstract expressionists who has suddenly discovered that what they were doing was very close, that was the last works of Monet have discovered. So it has been seen as an evidence in the 50s in USA. Because the last works of Monet, the Nymphaea, that we look with great admiration today, were not at all recognized at this moment when it has been installed at Orangerie in 27. So it was the artists have rediscovered. But so what we have done here today is to don't demonstrate an idea which is really well known today, but to make a real confrontation between the works. That is a completely new trip, nothing to see. You have to look to hear what the work of Monet and the work of Mitchell, the work, only the works, have to discuss between them, what they have in common, and what they have in common, it was certain subjects, that is very clear, but also very, very close, formal solution, and before all, the same objective, one wanted to translate only sensation, and the other, John, speak about feeling. And it's very moving to remember that at this moment of his life, when he was old, Monet said that he could leave all the rules of the painting, all the elementary rules of painting, was nothing for him. He wanted only to translate the sensation. And sensation is not completely the same than feeling for John, but very close. It's a mix of the perception, the emotion, and the memory of the emotion. It's at this mix. So at this moment, you realize that you can completely compare the two works.
Merci, madame.